Using the .env package, we can add a .env file to our project that serves as a central place to manage and document environment variables. This helps us update, maintain, and discover the environment variables an application needs. In this tutorial, we'll create a .env file for our local environment and populate it with some key value pairs. We'll use the .env package to read and parse the .env file and access the data it contains via the process.environment global variable. We'll also provide some additional thoughts about best practices for managing and documenting environment variables with a .env file. There are some real benefits to using a .env file. First is maintaining a central list of environment variables that your application needs to be set. Once you have more than a couple environment variables to worry about, managing them can be really cumbersome. .env files can also allow you to differentiate between different environments, keeping track of variables that are set in each different environment you're working with. For example, your environment variables are likely to have different values in local development versus in staging. Typing out your environment variables at the command line every time you execute your code is error-prone and tedious. Using a .env file helps you avoid making these mistakes and typos because you only have to write down the environment variable once in the file. By far, the most common solution in the Node.js world for managing environment variables is the .env package. It allows you to load your environment variables from a .env file at startup, so you don't have to worry about setting the environment variables anywhere else. The first rule when working with env files is to make sure that you do not commit them to version control. This is to ensure that you don't commit sensitive data like API keys and passwords into your version control system. To make sure that you don't ever accidentally commit your env file, you're going to want to put it into your .gitignore. So make sure that you edit your project's .gitignore to add your .env file to it. After updating the gitignore, make sure to add and commit it. Now npm install the .env package. Then create a .env file. This file usually lives in the root of your project directory. Open the env file in your editor, and you're ready to add your variables. The syntax is key value pairs, where the value comes after an equal sign. You can also add comments by adding a hash character before a line. Make sure to use one key value pair per line. It's typical to use the format where the keys are all in uppercase and separated by underscores. This isn't actually enforced or necessary, but it's typically what people end up doing. It's a common convention for environment variables to be all uppercase with words separated by underscores, like you see me doing here. To load the environment variables, we'll require .env and call its configure method as early in the code as possible. This is typically done in the main entry point of your program, typically the index.js file, somewhere at the very top. Calling config will look for a .env file in the same directory as the file we're currently in, and then load those environment variables into the process.env global variable. Now, if we run this file, we'll see our API host environment variable logged to the console. Now that the environment variables have been loaded, you'll be able to access them on the process.env global from any file in your project. Another useful way to manage these variables would be to create a config.js file which is responsible for calling .env and will export an object that has all of your configuration variables on it. To do that, let's first delete the required.env from this file. And then let's create a config.js file. Open config.js and let's require.env in this file instead. From this file, we're going to export an object which pulls together some of our environment variables as well as other application settings that we might want to set. What this allows us to do is mix some hard-coded configuration data with some environment variables which might change from environment to environment. If we go back to index.js, we can now require the config module and get the configuration details we want from there. This lets us access the hard-coded version config data as well as the environment variable set API host. Whenever you need the config data, you can just require this module in the file. It can also be very helpful to create an example.env file that you will commit into your project. This example.env should be either empty or have dummy data so that you're not committing anything sensitive. But creating an example.env will help other people know what environment variables need to be set. So let's copy our existing .env file and then make sure we go and edit it in order to delete our sensitive information. One last thing to note is that the .env package will not overwrite any environment variables which have already been set. So if we rerun this file and set the API host environment variable to example.com from the command line, we'll see that the CLI set environment variable takes precedent over the one that .env would have set. To recap, in this tutorial, we created a .env file and populated it with key value pairs. We then used the .env package in order to load those key value pairs into our process.env global. And we also discussed best practices around making sure that you don't commit your .env file, creating an example.env file, and generally the benefits of using .env files.